get to sing in this beautiful space. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Natasha Drake. I am from Minneapolis, but my family moved to Mankato, and so it is a real privilege to get to do my final farewell recital here. I just finished my master's degree, and I'm now moving to Leipzig, Germany in the fall to pursue a professional career. So I put together a program which I find very meaningful, and I'm really happy to share it with you. You'll see there are some titles on the sets for the first half. First set is entitled Americans Abroad, and the two composers represented both had significant careers in Europe, even though they are prototypical American composers. Ned Morham, he spent his formative years in Paris, and you can hear some of the sort of jazzy, languid Parisian harmonies in the selection that you just heard. Amy Beach is regarded as the first female composer from the United States of note. She was active in the late 19th century and early 20th. She wrote symphonies and chamber music and operas, but she is perhaps best known for her songs. She was married to a man 20 years her senior who allowed her to play concerts every once in a while. She was very well renowned as a concert pianist, but he would only allow her to play just a little bit, and just a couple concerts a year. And then he died, and then she ran away to Europe for 3 years and had a big career in Europe concertizing all over the place. Without further ado, two songs by Amy Beach.
Thank you.
pastors represented here have a connection to the city of Leipzig, which has a very long history of cultivating the very best in music and in composers. J.S. Bach worked in Leipzig churches for over 25 years and left a really indelible impression upon the city. He's buried there still. So to represent Bach, there is the famous setting by Gounod. It originated when Gounod was improvising over the famous first prelude. Robert Schumann is perhaps the best known composer after Bach with connections to the city. Robert Schumann was born in a city called Zwickau, which is not within Leipzig, but he traveled to Leipzig to study with Frederick Wieck, who was a very famous piano teacher at the time. Frederick Wieck had a young daughter named Clara, and even though Robert was in his early 20s when he started studying with Wieck, he fell in love with the adolescent Clara right away. They had to wait until she was 21 years old for them to get married. Frederick Wieck was not very happy that his student had seduced his daughter. And there was something about Clara that really led to this enormous outpouring of sentiment. And you can see that in Robert's sudden turn towards song composition. Robert and Clara married in the year 1840, and this year is often called the Liederjahr, the year of songs. Robert wrote 140 songs in a single year, so it's one every couple of days. And this song cycle that I'm going to perform some selections for you, Mutin, was written as a wedding gift to Clara. So it's particularly poignant and full of beautiful, tender imagery. Clara loved the Schubert setting of Ave Maria, and Robert decided to work the melody of that famous lead into the end of it, and I'm going to ask Ben to play the final measures of it so you can hear, and when I perform it in a couple minutes, you'll be able to pick up. Applause in between songs. Antonin Dvorak in Bohemia, and Sibelius in Finland, really wanted to find a sort of native art music for his country of Norway. And so this song cycle is regarded as perhaps his finest composition, and is his effort toward that. The poem, poetry by Arni Garborg, tells of a young maiden who is ostracized by her community because she has sensitivity to the supernatural. She is in communication with the trolls underneath the mountain. However, this is only hinted at very vaguely in the poems that Grieg decided to set. On the outset, the narrative is a more conventional one of a young woman that falls in love and then gets rejected. But if you read the poetry, you may get a sense that she perhaps sees more than other people. Anyway, it's a beautiful song cycle. I hope you enjoy.
Oh. Thank you. Thank you.
Lustige Witwe by Franz Lehár.